One day, a Punitalau, that hero of the Tinggians, went down to the lowlands. Wandered aimlessly through the plains until he reached the seashore. On and on he rode until he came to the edge of the world. There, in a place where the sea and the sky meet, a Punitalau saw a towering rock, home of the Lord of the Sea, Lord Tau Mariyu. It was guarded by the 9 beautiful daughters of the seaweed. Gathering his courage, the Tinggian warrior went nearer the palace gate. Punitalau hurriedly picked up the unconscious body of the sea maiden, loaded it on his boat, and rowed shoreward. Shortly after the Tinggian hero had left the valley gate, Lord Tau Mariyu went out in his boat to see what the commotion was all about.
Who are you? Why are you taking my Humitau? I summoned the waves, tunas, to save my Humitau. Kill the intruder!
Lord Tau Mariyu was furious. He immediately called a meeting of the gods and the demigods of the seas and the oceans, who agreed to banish the dwellers of the land for what a Punitalau had done.
Gods and goddesses, hear me out. There's an intruder in my kingdom and took my Humitau, one of my sea maidens. I want justice!
Shall be given to you.
From the sky, Lang'an knew the plan. She immediately called for the North Wind and sent him to warn her son of the impending flood. She instructed the mountain lord to go to the highest peak of the Caldera Mountain for safety.
Your mother sent me a message. There's a great flood coming. Run to the highest mountain for your safety. I will do as you command.
Obediently, Apunipulau took the members of his household to the mountain top and waited. The flood came. Apunipulau saw the mighty waves sweeping across the plain, killing the valley and destroying the crops and working animals of the inhabitants. Higher and higher went the water until it covered the mountain top. Frightened, Humitau gave a desperate cry. He knew that she no longer swim or live in the water after having tasted the mountain food which her husband had given her. The charm removed her sea power. Despite his anger, the water lord took pity upon his favorite Humitau. So he called back the water and the waves. But he promised that henceforth he would sink men's boats and drown passengers until Apunipulau's crime would be appeased.
My child, I shall call upon the waters and waves.
Humitau!
To sink the boats of men until Apunipulau's crime is given.
When the water subsided, Apunipulau and his wife went down to the lowland.
I witness this wedding and bless these children. By name, we shall be husband and wife. This is a proof.
Now, you shall be my wife. Will you accept me?
Lord, we
love.